In this lesson, we're going to take a look at creating images in plane mirrors, as well as the common characteristics of images in plane mirrors. So just a quick recap of some terminology that we need to remember. Normal is a perpendicular line 90 degrees to the plane mirror where the light is going to be striking the mirror. Angle of incidence is measured between the incident ray and the normal. Angle of reflection is measured between the normal and the reflected ray. And the law of reflection states that the angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. So when we want to describe an image, we use the SALT acronym. So SALT, size, attitude, location, and type. So when referring to size, we always compare it back to the original object. So our original object, we're going to compare, is our image larger, smaller, or the same? In terms of its attitude, it can either be upright or inverted. And again, always comparing to the original object. The location, is it in front or behind the mirror? So does the image appear to be in front or behind the mirror? And is it virtual or real? So virtual means you won't actually show up on a screen, and real means if you were to put your hand or piece of paper there, it would show up on a screen. So let's go into those definitions a little bit more detail. So a real image is an image that can be seen on a screen as a result of light rays actually hitting or arriving at an image location. So if you have light rays hitting or arriving at that table, you can see that image there. If you were to put your hand in front of it, that image would also show on your hand. That is a real image. Camera projectors, movie projectors, things like that create real images because there are real light rays arriving to produce that image. A virtual image, on the other hand, is formed because of an apparent light source. It's not actually coming from the actual image. So what happens is, in order to see an image, light rays have to come to your eye. So if we have a light source here in this candle, those light rays are coming and reflecting off that mirror, and they're going to hit your eye. But our brain intuitively knows that light travels in straight lines. So our brain extrapolates those light rays backwards behind the mirror and imagines or pictures that the image to be behind the mirror. So it's an apparent source. The light rays didn't actually come from that location, but our brain interprets them to come from that location. So a virtual image, if you were to actually put your hand at the location of where your brain thinks that image is, nothing would show up on your hand or the piece of paper or a screen. So a real image has to show up on a screen. A virtual image will not. It appears to be behind the mirror. So how do we create an image? It depends, first of all, about perspective. Is even though all of these observers are looking in the same mirror, okay, they're going to see those light rays as if they're coming from the same place, but the light rays are going to be hitting their eyes at different angles. So how do we determine where that image is actually going to be for each of the observers? Well, let's take a simple example to start. If we're to draw a mirror, okay, again, the reflective side is the one without the hash marks, and we have a simple object. A light ray is going to come from that object and hit the mirror. We follow the law of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. So we can draw our normal, measure our angle between the normal and the incident ray, create the same angle between the normal and the reflected ray, and draw the reflected ray. Okay, take another arbitrary light ray, incident ray, from that object, another arbitrary angle hitting the mirror, draw yourself a normal, draw the reflected ray. Now, in order to determine where that object would appear, you would extrapolate those reflected rays backwards in a straight line behind the mirror. The point at which they intersect or cross is where the object would actually appear to our eyes. Okay? So our eyes would see those light rays, and it would extrapolate those rays backwards, and that's where the image would appear to form. Okay? So how do we actually draw it then? Let's put an object over here of an arrow. Always good to have an object where you can clearly distinguish top and bottom. Let's take an incident ray coming in. And if we were to measure our angle of reflection, we could draw our reflected ray. You always want to take your rays from the tip and the bottom of your object. So in this case, the arrow, we're going to take a light ray coming from the tip. The angle is arbitrary that it hits the mirror, right? We would then take that reflected ray, and we're just going to leave, for simplicity here, we're just going to leave the reflected ray on. Take another incident ray. Again, angle is arbitrary. Draw the reflected ray. And we're going to take those two reflected rays and extrapolate them back in a straight line. The point at which they intersect is going to be where the top of that arrow would be for the image. We're going to repeat the process for the bottom of the object. Draw an incident ray, draw its corresponding reflected ray, pick another ray from the bottom of this arrow coming in, arbitrary angle, draw its reflected ray following the law of reflection, extrapolate those two reflected rays back. The point at which they cross is where the bottom of that arrow be, because that's where you took the light rays from or the incident rays from. So you would note your image would appear in this location. So if you were to actually take it and a ruler and to measure it, you would notice that the length from the object to the mirror is going to be equivalent from the mirror to the actual image. Same thing, the tail of the arrow to the mirror is going to be the same. So that's one way you can double check to see if you've done things correctly. Is this distance equal to this distance here? Is this distance equal to this distance? Because everything is going to appear to be the same distance behind the image as it was in front. So how do we draw it if we want to put it out in steps? First, you have to draw your plane mirror, then draw an object, okay? Draw an incident ray from the object to the mirror, draw your small normal and the reflected ray, change the angle from the object, coming from the same place on the object that you drew that first incident ray, draw another incident ray, reflected off the mirror, extend those two reflected rays in straight lines behind the mirror until they cross or intersect, and that is where the object is located, or the point of the object that you took the original incident rays from. Now, there has to be an easier way, and there is. We have to understand why images appear where they appear to be able to understand this this method. So if we're using this only for plane mirrors or flat mirrors, okay, notice we have an object here. We can measure from the tip to the mirror. That we know is going to be the same distance from the mirror to the tip of our image. The base to the mirror is going to be the same. So we can measure two or three points of an object and show its reflected image without having to do all the incident rays and reflected rays. But be careful on quizzes or tests. You might be asked to actually draw the rays, or you could ask to just simply show where the image is and you could use this method. Okay? Same thing. Any object is going to appear the equal distance behind the mirror. One thing to notice though, all plane mirrors will have a lateral or horizontal reflection. So that's why in the front of ambulances, the word is actually written backwards, because in a car, your rear view mirror is a plane mirror. So when you look up in the mirror, you can actually read the word ambulance. So lateral inversion images are going to be horizontally flipped, right? You wave yourself in the mirror with your right hand. It's the left hand of the image that waves back at you. So all images in plane mirrors will have these salt characteristics. They're always the same size. If we look at this image here, it's the same size as the original object. They will all be upright or right side up, but they will be laterally or horizontally inverted or flipped. Location, they will appear behind the mirror, the same distance as the object was from the mirror, and they will be virtual. If you actually put your hand or piece of paper behind the mirror where that image appears to be, nothing will show up because there are no actual light rays at that point. Okay? Now, these characteristics remain this way for all images in plane mirrors. Okay? Some uses of plane mirrors, cosmetic mirrors, if you want to see things at the same size, rear view mirrors, periscopes work that same way. Okay? Anytime you want an image with those characteristics, you would use a plane mirror.